Jay Shrek. Man, we're on an adventure today to try to find a way to get into the Gila riverbed. And we've come to the end of a road that really wasn't the end of the road. But what we found is we've got this trail, and this definitely man-made. They definitely have stacked these rocks out of this area right here. We're trying to see how bad it is to get up in here. But we've got ourselves on one hell of a journey. Now, I'm guessing this used to be a stage route, because ranchers wouldn't have put this much work into this that I see. This had to have been some type of stage route coming through here. But to see these stacked rocks, this is real close to what you see at Oatman. So somebody has stacked that, and I'm going to guess this was some type of stagecoach route or something like that. But we might be at our stopping point right here. No, we're good. It's been a better ATV route than it would have been a route through here in the truck. But this is the real deal right here. We are not messing around today. Man, can you believe this? And you know, it's about 8 o'clock and it's already 80 degrees. Can you believe that? Summer's definitely right around the corner, but we got a chance to come back down here. And this trail kind of looked like it stopped, but the more you got into it, the more you realized that it's kind of funny where this is going to take us. I'm not sure if this is going to take us where we want to go or not, but you know it goes somewhere. So I'm not even sure. So maybe it takes us on top of the mesa. Wow, what an adventure we're on today. I tell you what, this is incredible. I need to walk this though to make sure that there's no points in which we're going to have difficulty. Pretty nice ditch there, but not impossible to cross. And somebody's definitely been working it. So we'll walk on up here. Man, we've got ourselves a great adventure today, trying to get to the Gila River bottoms. And this is going to take us right up on top, it looks like. So how incredible is this that we're, like I said, we're on an adventure today. But this is going to take us right up on the top, it looks like, which is pretty fascinating. So, man, what a great day this is going to be. What do you guys think? I'm going to pop up over that hill, try to make sure that we can see where this is going. And if you'll notice, first adventure this year that I popped the shorts out. Well, I went up to the top of that ridge and it just looks like it goes out and on and on. So what I'm going to do is go back to the truck and then we'll make a decision whether we want to go this way or not. It's a big bird of prey up there. I don't know if you saw him. We're out in it today. There's no doubt. So now that we've looked at that, we'll just have to make a decision whether we want to try to go that way or not. Tell you what, the old FJ is doing the deal today. He's definitely doing the dance today. He's doing his job. That is a good truck right there. If you're looking for a great four-wheel drive vehicle, you ain't gonna get much better than this one right here. Let's get in. Who is that?
Wanna go for a ride, big boy?
Yeah, I do. Okay, today we are off the beaten path today for sure. We have definitely done some trailblazing today. There's the old road right there, which is the original road that they used. And this is a newer road, which is actually better. But you can see, you know, these stack rocks, you know, somebody spent a lot of time stacking that rock and getting it in here like this. And so that's very proof that there's some type of trail. And there can't be that many trails that go through the Gila Bend area. So when you get one of them, you start to realize that there's going to be very few that come through here that could do a wagon train. So I'm thinking about this as the wagon train path, and I could be totally off on that, but I really believe it is. You know what's so nice is the original trail is terrible, but that one was perfect because the original trail went up that outside. It was a tough one out here. And you know, we just came down the road coming in from that peak up there that you saw. And then look what we found. Here's a grave here, you know? And a lot of old cans, a lot of metal strapping, some more of that blue glass. But you know, this is somebody's burial place down here. We don't know whose it is, but you know what? It's pretty incredible that we found that there. It really is. And now if this was a stagecoach route, it'd make total sense. Got a lot of metal and stuff. I mean, that's, somebody put that there deliberately. And so was that an old miner, you know? Who knows? Looks like an old metal tin right here, tobacco tin. Yeah, I'm not sure. Leave that be though. I kind of want to look at this stuff. That old, boy, that's old right there. That, man, that is old. Look at that, John. This ring looks like a, yeah. Horseshoe.
Yeah, you think this is a grave?
Yeah, I do.
That was underwater.
That rock there was underwater.
Absolutely.
Can you tell because it's smooth?
Well, with all the instruction you gave me, I can't miss them anymore.
See, everybody's got to be a smart ass on the trail. Why is that? You know, I think it's because he's a smart ass all the time, not just on the trail. I think that's really it. So let's go down this ridge. We're going to check these ridges out up here because I think right now we're in ancient land. And I tell you what, they were down here. So we're going to see if we can't find some homesteads because we found an angle. So it looks like that road right there goes out. And we don't really want to go out right now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab a couple of waters. John's headed over here. I'm gonna take a look at some of these points over here and just see if we see any signs of any petroglyphs. Because we believe that the ancients worked these cliff sites all the way down to the river. This would have been like a tributary right here. So the water would have flowed down here, but it wouldn't have been completely from bank to bank, as you're seeing here and here. But, you know, they would have been all above those mesas and in this area right here. Now, I do see, I thought for a minute we had a road, but I don't think it is. I don't tell you what, these black rock, it's incredible how much hotter it is when you walk through these lava fields like this. And, you know, as I told you today, I've got shorts on today. And I think what these rocks are going to tell me is that I don't think we've got anything. That's a perfect area up there for petroglyphs. So if there's no petroglyphs there, then we know that we're just, we're too far down. They're going to be closer up to that point. Because there are some perfect places, in my estimation, on that point where there would be petroglyphs. And we'll see. Another thing we're looking at also is telegraph poles. They had a telegraph that came across here. Now, they got it done really cheap, but they did really a terrible job. And so the poles weren't very tall, and cows would break the line. So there was a lot of, spent a lot of time keeping that thing going. And wasn't too popular. It's good for a while. You know, John saw some interesting rocks right here. And they're not in a natural position. They're not from this area right here. And you know what? It's funny how they kind of point direction. Right? That would take you to the main channel right there. That takes you out. And then you know what? Then I would know going out, the stage route is over there. And then, you know, we saw the grave over here. And so it just, it's interesting this stuff is going on in this middle of this bed. For our work today, though, we're just a little too far up. But one thing we wanted to do was make sure there wasn't things down here that we knew of. So at least we have accomplished that. We can eliminate this off our list. So you're going to go on this at the same time I do. Now expect there to be all kinds of stuff up here to explore. And I'm expecting this to be an incredible journey today. And I'm looking to try to catch on a trail. Now anything could be in this location, geoglyphs. Now I don't know how far across this mesa is. We might have a pretty good hike to get across it to see. Now, one thing I'll do when I get out here is I will find a trail. So here's one right here. This is an ancient trail. This isn't new. They've been working this trail for 1,000 years. So what we're going to do is we're going to get on this trail and we're going to let it carry us to wherever our location is. Now, sometimes it works like this and sometimes it doesn't. You just don't know what you're going to get into out here. But the bottom line is there's a time where you just got to start hiking. And it's a little warm today. I've got extra water. But I'm expecting to see some, probably the best petroglyphs I've ever seen. So I'm expecting that. So we're just checking this out. Now, one thing I did find was I found a mountain lion tracks. So we definitely have a mountain lion out here, and man, their feet are so big. Exploring something that's considered to be the capital of the ancient civilization was here. You know, you got a special place. So let's take a look out here again. Kind of lost my trail, but I know where I'm going. I'm going straight across. Now, man, I hope you guys are excited about this as I am. This is going to be a pretty big deal, but we got a long, long way to go. So I'm not not worried about that. You know, we need to find what we need to find today because, you know, this rock, I've talked about this before, but the heat that's in this brownish black rock is incredible. And I mean, you can raise the level or temperature 10 to 20 degrees by just being in this environment. You know, I just got to a point where looks like I finally might have got to the edge, but man, it took a long time to get over here. My gosh, here's what we got. Here's what we're looking at. Now, this should be an incredible location right here. And now what I'm looking at, so what do I look at? See how green that is in the Gila basin there? See how green that is? Well, from what I've learned is they usually drew on the rocks that were closest to the river. So when I find that green area down there, that's when I hug that rock face or that area. So what I'm gonna do is find a point to start at. Now, this isn't the greatest area to have done petroglyphs, but definitely doable. Nice trail that runs across there. That would have been a good area right there. And so would that point out there be. So that's the point I saw earlier right there. So we'll see where that goes to. And it looks like this is where, at least this is a good starting point right here. Now, they definitely could have been on that point. I hate to go all the way out and then all the way back, but I could come back and then and follow that fence line down. What do you guys think? What do you guys think? You know, I'm guaranteed that way. If I head back that way, I'm guaranteed that I'm going to run into stuff. That is a guess, but that would be something that I've never seen. I don't see anything on this ridge over here, which would be great petroglyph points. I'm going to walk right over here, and then we're going to make a call that at least we got to the point. It's kind of interesting dig out right there, but I don't see anything that shows any ancient culture here right now. You know, it's not really a gamble because I know I'm going to find stuff that direction. The only thing is I might find stuff the other direction that is some unique stuff that most people wouldn't get to. Most people wouldn't walk this far from the point where they think the stuff's at. But if I go this way, I hear bees. We'll keep walking. And we'll go across this lava field right here. You know, how beautiful is that right there? I think we found our first petroglyphs, actually. Right there, that's the first ones I've seen that I can see it on that wall over there. So that's the first. I haven't seen anything else up here. Now, I thought I saw petroglyphs. I'm usually pretty good at this. But let's see. Yep, I was correct. Looky there. So that's the first petroglyphs I've seen so far. Right here. Those are extremely old. Extremely old. Got a kind of a nice, it's like a larger deer down here. Really difficult to see. Let's get down here. It's like, I see other people's footprints, so I'm not the only one that's walked around that point. Looks like some archaic stuff over there. It's not a lot, but you know, right here, I can already tell you I'm seeing footprints of other people that's tried to dig in. So I'm not the only one that's been down this path. Boy, it's slick stuff, as I can tell by their footprints. So, what do we have other than beautiful rocks? But we've seen our first sign, which is critical. You gotta start somewhere. So we've seen our first sign. So what we're gonna do is, we're gonna climb back up here. It's a lot steeper than you think it is. So I'm gonna walk up these man-made stairs. We're gonna get out of here, pull up this, work our way up that, get our legs ripped off. Here's another sign right there, small circle. So, good stuff. Means we're on the right path. So let's loop around there. Whew. That was close. So now we're gonna go down until we hopefully catch on to another group. Now that's really a strange down there when you look how that groove runs down through there. Very interesting. And the way that's all green. And there's another point way back down there too, I couldn't see it. But I really almost guarantee you that was a site down there. There's one right there. That's not just haphazardly rock stacked. That definitely is a sign of something right there. And there's another one right here. So we need to take a look what's down here. That's definitely something right there. You know, that could have been over there for 900 years. That's crazy when you think about it. Then here was an old fence post right here. This very well could have been an encampment right here. But I'm getting into an area, man, look at the amount of, we got some predators up here. Look at that. Look at that washing down there. That is incredible. We might have a nest in here pretty, somewhere close. But I'm telling you what, we got some predators in here. You know, I've been walking about, man, mile and a quarter. quarter, and I have not seen anything. I mean, absolutely nothing. Nothing on the top, nothing on the bottom. The only thing I've seen is, man, there's a bunch of predator birds that own this area. Now, I know I've got to be coming in to petroglyphs. You know, one thing I'll tell you what I'm trying to do is, man, I am trying to make sure that I stay hydrated. You know, half of this stuff is you just don't know what you're going to get into when you do it. You know, so a lot of this is, man, the work you got to do. So how do you find this stuff? Sometimes you just keep walking. You know, I saw this edge over here. I'm going to take a look. I really like the rock style. And I'm going to kind of come around this point and try not to. And again, I'm seeing footprints. So somebody else had the same idea I did. So hopefully they were as cautious as I'm going to be. But I liked what I saw as far as these walls. Now, first thing I'm going to do is any bees? Okay, I see a couple glyphs, so and I don't see any bees. So those are the first two greatest things I've heard. But I've already seen footprints, so I'm not the only one that's ever been down here. So let's take a look. See if we see anything. There's some old glyphs right there. Okay, there's an interesting piece right there. So let's take a look at that real quick. Got a nice deer right there. I think that's a deer. So now we know we're in some glyphs. So let's take a look. Again, I see somebody else's footprints. So I'm not the only guy that's been down here. So, see if we see any bees. I probably got here at this area the absolute worst time. Because the way the sun is. And again, I'm following somebody else's footprints. Oh, there's a nice panel right there. I wish you could see it. So if I can't get back, get a better look at it. That's a nice panel right there. Hard to see, very old, but that is beautiful. That's a good panel. That's the best I've seen so far. So that means I'm getting in an area where we definitely have ancient activity here. So let's keep moving on. There's a nice one right there. There's one to the back side of this. Oh, look at that. Look at that firebird. Or turkey, maybe that's a turkey. That's pretty cool. Now look at that concrete piece down there. They have been trying to divert and control this river since the beginning of time, since man first laid eyes on this location and this river. They've been trying to control and maintain this. Look at the size of that floodplain right there. And then at one time, the river came right along here, along these banks. But there's some remnants of men again where, you know, they've tried to control this. Now, I'm getting into a honey hole because I feel it. Look at that. That's pretty cool. I got a lot down here, but I'll tell you what. It's a nice deer right there. Whatever it is, got a little stuff in my eye. But I love those hands. Those hands are pretty cool. You know, I've seen a couple things. Nothing like I expected. I mean, I expected to see a lot of stuff. Really haven't seen that much. Not disappointed yet. I still believe it's here. But that cliff over there looks really promising. Over there. And I see petroglyphs, I believe, on them bottom rocks. So if they're there, they should be down around this corner, I'm thinking. There's our bird right there. Look at him. Haven't done. Oh, look at there. So there's a nest over here. Okay, here we are. I see some interesting stuff down on those rocks. I see a lot of stuff starting to come in. I think I'm on a cliff face here where there is maybe some stuff here. If I can figure out how to get down there. I definitely see stuff on these rocks here. I think we might have found our spot. Wow, look at those. Look at that. Look at those structures down there. Not sure if this is the same location I was at earlier or not, but this thing goes forever. I don't think so, only because I don't know where I would have come out at. This is some cool stuff. There's a fence. I thought I remembered the fence from my last travels. You know, we might be back in the same area coming from the different side. Wow. There's stuff all over those rocks down below. Just gotta figure out a way to get down there. And I don't remember it. Well, you don't fall down there. There's something down there. Oh, do you see that? See that owl? See that owl going across there? We got in his house. At least they heard. Look down there. Wow. We got some weird, weird stuff. Down in there. Don't want to fall in there, that's for sure. Look at this crazy stuff. Wow. This is incredible. Look at this. Tell you what, we might even grab two hands on this. Don't want to fall there, that'd be instant death. Down in there. Tell you what, this is exploring here. Holy smokes. Wow. Now look at those rocks down below on the bottom. Stuff all over there. Down in there. Tell you what, we want to be careful crossing this right here. That would be a bad day at the ranch. We ain't at the ranch. Wow, I'll tell you what. Hanging out there a little bit. Look at those beautiful chocolate rocks. Wow. Wow. Man, I'm telling you what. It's another world. Look how crazy this is. I don't see any bees. There's something flying around. I'm gonna run around this way. You know, I don't know if there's anything down here after I made this climb. I don't see anything. This might be as good a place as any, though, to go ahead and go to the bottom and work my way through to see what's down there. I'm already here. I'm halfway down, so I might as well take a look. Tell you what, this is not. These rocks are unbelievably hot. So we're gonna start looking from the bottom up, see what we got. Okay, look at this rock. That's gotta look maybe some red in it. Look at there, look at that guy. He is awesome. Look at that. Okay, we're in some special little place right here. Okay, this is something we haven't seen. Look at these holes in this rock right here. They definitely were working down here. So we're in a sacred place right here. The only problem I'm having is the reflection off these are so strong. It's hard to see. That whole rock's covered. Boy, that looks like something right there. I don't know what. Looks like it's been sitting there for 100 years. Look at that. Is that a petroglyph like that? Wow. That's pretty incredible right there. Looks like it's a rock that's been worked, definitely. I've been on there a long time. Look at that. That's definitely been worked. That's definitely been worked. That rock there. Same with it. So this is an area they were working down here. Tell you what, it's extremely warm out here. Extremely warm. This whole entire rock has been worked. Look up there, how majestic is that? The only problem with that is we got to get back. Boy, this was a sacred point right here. Look at that beautiful piece. Look at this whole rock structure. They were working all over here. And these stones were definitely stones that they've been working in this area. Look at all that. This is like one of the most spectacular little clumps I've ever seen right here. How cool is this? This is absolutely spectacular. Look at that archaic piece right there. That is beautiful. Wow. You know, there's markings all over here. This was a special little spot right here. And then there's 1975. A something, and then there is 1893 right there. A lot of people have been here. You can tell by the way it's all worn out. Well, this was a special little clump. I don't know, somebody else has been walking through here, some animal or something. I don't know if that means there's something else down here, or they were just double checking to make sure they didn't miss anything either. I'll tell you what, it's tough to see down here. It's just because the reflection off those black rocks. But I'm telling you what, I see something here that is incredible, even with this. And hopefully the sun doesn't blow up these pictures, because the reflection is just absolutely unbelievable. Look at that. That is incredible right there. Man, we got our work cut out for us today. Oh, yeah. Oh, knees. Don't burn up. Somebody's walked through there. Kind of funny how you can see somebody else's trail, especially after you do this a while, and you're like, okay, is that the best way to go through? You know, who knows? You only know until you, when you're done, was that easy or not. Oh, I heard a little bee action, and I was like, oh no. Oh, that's cutting a little, that's a little leg action. That dry grass, man, that grass is slick. Ooh. So far I haven't paid for wearing shorts yet. The hike's still early, but haven't paid yet. You know, I really thought I'd see a lot more down here. And I have. Hopefully I'll be able to sneak out of here. Tell you what, there ain't a lot of easy ways out of here. I'm telling you what. Once you get in here, I'm telling you what, there ain't a lot of easy ways out of here. Whew. Well, see what that is? That's climb out. There's an animal cave right there. Glad he ain't in there. Wow, we got, you know what? We might have us a hell of a time getting out of here. tell you what, I'm not seeing a very good damn route out of here. I'm gonna put you away for this one, I'm telling you. If you can tell already, I got a hell of a hike up this ridge. But I don't see another way. Right here, I'm kind of stuck. So, probably gonna take me a good 20, 25 minutes to get out of here. Reminds me of Sears Point a little bit. Well, I don't know if you can see that, like that turkey. It's the second one of those we've seen. Look at that big panel up there with all those checkerboards. Extremely difficult to see. Pretty damn cool. Look what I got to go up. I tell you what, this was a monster. And I tell you what, these rocks are roasting me. Trying to find a little bit of shade. Take a little bit of cover for a second. Man, whew. I tell you what, this is a monster. Wow. One side of me wants to rest. The other side of me is like, get out of here. Man. Oh. Oh, I came from down there. Tell you what, that was a hike. It's getting out of there. Wow. Oh, unreal. Well, I was in the same area as quail when I got attacked by bees, but I went to the bottom. And I'll tell you what, that was a lot of work, man. One smart thing I did today was I got some sodium in me, and I got plenty of water. I still got 2 bottles of water left, but I took 5, and that, for this short of a hike, a couple 3 hours maybe when I get done. Wow, I tell you what, unbelievable place. Still wouldn't give it up for the world. I still wouldn't change what I'm doing for anything. I tell you what, it's too fun, too unbelievable I get to do this. And a lot of that's because of the Patreon people that I have and the good friends I have that can help me on these adventures. And man, you don't realize how much I appreciate that. That is unreal. Well, I got me a little water, got hydrated back up. I'm walking on the moon right now. I think I know where I'm going. One thing you don't realize is when you're walking in this, man, the amount of heat coming off this is unbelievable. I don't know exactly where I'm going. Got a pretty good idea. I won't know till I get through here, but man, I don't want to drag around too long, I'm telling you. Not only the reflection is unbelievable, the heat is really strong. We hiked a long way today. Hey, I want to thank everybody that has liked, subscribed, and if you are a Patreon subscriber, thank you very much. I appreciate that. One of the reasons I'm out here right now is that, and thank everybody for the support. And Man, it was a good trip today. I mean, we didn't get everything we're looking for, but you don't always. But we did see that, what a cool place, man. That was the capital of that ancient tribe, was considered by this in the 1800s. So isn't that unbelievable? So this was a hive of activity. No pun on the fact I got stung by bees last time I was here. But thanks for coming along, man. I appreciate you. Subscribe, hit that notification bell if you can. And I would like to buy a little gas. We'd much appreciate it. And we'll see you on down the trail. And thanks again. And have a great evening. And man, if you're going to be out in this stuff like this, man, be careful. I've been training all year so far for this exact hike so far. And thank goodness I'm in pretty good shape to be able to do that, because it's a long way back to the truck. Take care. I'll see you later. Thanks for coming along. Hope you had a good time. See ya.